Hey guys, so today we are going to make an acorn polymer clay cane, and for today I'm going to use three colors. I'm going to use cadmium yellow, burnt umber translucent, and also some black clay. These are the tools that I will be using for my project today. So to begin with, let's start by using some burnt umber. Here I'm using three parts of burnt umber. And I'm going to mix this with cadmium yellow to get a milk chocolatey color of clay. These two colors will be mixed properly so that I could get one consistent color of the milk chocolate color. This will be my main part of the acorn. Now I have conditioned this clay to my thickest setting of number 2 on my pasta machine, and I'm taking 5 parts of this color. Now I'm stacking one on top of the other so that I need it as one roll of clay. Make sure to press it properly so that there are no air bubbles in between. Next, I'll be using my needle tool, and I'm just going to roughly draw a shape of an acorn. So this is the shape that I'm just outlining, and using my flexible blade, I'm just going to cut the outline of what I just drew. Using your fingers, you can just smudge the edges and make sure you get the shape of the corn. I'm just going to use my knife to just smoothen the edges that was not proper before. Now this is properly pressed and the edges are smudged properly. I'm just going to make sure the tip of the corn is a little pointy. That's the actual shape of an acorn. Now I keep that aside, and now I'm going to take my burnt umber, and again I'm going to use 5 parts of the burnt umber. This one is also conditioned on my second setting on the pasta machine. The second setting on my pasta machine is quite thick, so I have used the thickest one. Again, I'm pressing the clay properly. I've stacked it, and now I have I'm going to now outline the top part portion of my acorn, again using the needle tool. Now cutting it off using my flexi blade. For my black clay, I have used the sixth setting on my pasta machine, and I'm just going to make some strips of this is the size that I need for my to insert this. I need a crisscross design on the top portion of my acorn, so I'm just going to take a few strips. to diagonally cut each part and then insert the black clay in between to give that crisscross design. Just make sure that when you're using the black strip, when you're making the crisscross design, it should be in the thinnest setting, because if you use the thicker setting, the top part of the acorn clay that we use, it will start to extend and the size will not be right. So this is the reason why I have used the thinner setting of my black clay. The same process again on the other side and to get that crisscross design. Once this is done, I'm using the same burnt umber and I'm just going to cover the entire just the sides, the outer part and the inner part of my the top portion. So this part is also on the thinnest setting. I have used the sixth thinnest setting on my pasta machine, and this is how I'm just going to cover just the sides. I'll be leaving the top part and the bottom part. We don't want to cover the top part and the bottom part. That when we make the clay, it has to be pressed properly so that there are as much as possible, there are no gaps in between. When there are gaps in your cane, it will not give a proper design. Now my top portion of the acorn is ready now. Now I need a little bit of my stem that I need to fix. Using the same burnt umber again on the thicker setting, the second thicker setting, I'm just going to make 5 strips. I'll be stacking them one on top of the other. Just need a small portion of the stem, so I'm just taking a small portion. Now we have all 3 parts of an acorn ready. Now we are going to just assemble them together. Now now that our design is ready, now I'm going to fill it. I need a square shape for my cane, so I'm just going to fill the gaps with some translucent clay. I've used all my clay here is being used with Primo Sculpey. So this is something that works well for me. I keep layering it a bit by bit so that every portion is being covered. The entire portion of the design is being covered with my for the cane. So this is how the final the cane is now after using all the translucent clay. I have covered the portion of my design with the translucent clay, and this is the square part. Now after a lot of pulling and pushing, this is how my cane would be like. So I'm just going to reduce it even further. Make sure that you push and pull on all sides, and now for the big reveal. Voila, that's my cane.